गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून, क्या हो गया? कोई ज्वाइन नहीं कर रहा? कल भी कोई ज्वाइन नहीं किया?
सर कल ये कल हमारा क्लास था
3 बजे?
4 बजे तक, 4 बजे तक, 2 से 4,
ओके,
और ऊपर से वो क्लास कल ही खत्म हो गया, इसीलिए।
ठीक है, बढ़िया है। बट कैलेंडर पे तो कुछ नहीं दिखा रहा। कैलेंडर पे जो वीकली शेड्यूल है उसमें कुछ नहीं शो कर रहा।
कैलेंडर में सर आपका क्लास ही नहीं है, इसीलिए शायद कोई
हाँ
ज्वाइन नहीं
नहीं,
कर रहा है।
मैंने इसीलिए मैंने मेल किया ना
हाँ
सेपरेटली।
वो मैं ग्रुप में डाल दे रहा हूँ।
नहीं मतलब कोई जिसको अभी तो जैसे कॉलेज का जो सिलेबस है वो तो खत्म हो गया है, किसी को करना है तो ठीक है, नहीं करना है तो कोई बात नहीं, कोई प्रेशर नहीं है।
नहीं वो लोग जहाँ ठीक से शायद नोटिस नहीं किए होंगे, तो इसीलिए
ओके ठीक
मैं
है
बोल रहा था तुझे
ठीक है।
चाहिए
तो
तो ज्वाइन कर।
लो पॉली इज रेडी। जो लो पॉली बनाने के बाद व्हाट आई डिड इज आई यूज्ड स्मूथ सब डिवीजन, एक सब डिवीजन ऐड किया मैंने इसमें जस्ट टू मेक द मॉडल लिटिल डिटेल्ड एंड स्मूथ। पूरा लो पॉली बनाया, पूरा सेंटर लाइन है, एवरीथिंग क्लीन। सब कुछ करने के बाद एंड जस्ट सिंपली एडेड वन लाइन सेंटर में, लाइक दिस थिंग, सब डिवाइडेड दिस थिंग, ताकि थोड़ा सा डिटेल मिल जाए ओवरऑल मेश में। नाउ नाउ आई नीड टू बेक डिस्प्लेसमेंट मैप। सो इसके लिए लाइक व्हाट आई पर्सनली प्रेफर, बेक इट फ्रॉम जी ब्रश इटसेल्फ रादर की यूज सम थर्ड पार्टी सॉफ्टवेयर लाइक एक्स नॉर्मल और मे बी माया मैक्स। यू कैन बेक डिस्प्लेसमेंट मैप। इट्स ए वे टू टाइम कंज्यूमिंग प्रोसेस एंड देर इज नो गारंटी की गेट द राइट रिजल्ट। बट फ्रॉम जी ब्रश आई एम प्रिटी श्योर, लाइक 100% श्योर यू विल गेट राइट रिजल्ट। सो अभी सो व्हाट आई डिड फॉर नाउ आई नीड टू बेक डिस्प्लेसमेंट। सो फॉर दैट आई नीड टू ओपन माई जी ब्रश मॉडल।
तो प्रैक्टिकल का कुछ स्टेट वगैरह बोलिए।
प्रैक्टिकल का आई गेस टेस्ट शायद नहीं होगा बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दिस लाइक सिचुएशन एंड ऑल, बट थ्योरी एग्जाम्स तो है ही एंड एक्सटर्नल आई एम नॉट श्योर अभी तक एक्सटर्नल का क्या होगा। एक्सटर्नल में अभी तक आपको हमारे पास अपडेट नहीं आया है, तो मतलब जैसे प्रैक्टिकल एग्जाम्स के अगर वो तो वो आएगा तो विल गेट वो उसके
नहीं क्योंकि
एग्जाम।
हमको जो मेल भेजे था उसमें लिखे थे अक्टूबर में होगा, तो अक्टूबर तो बहुत लेट नहीं हो रहा है अक्टूबर में अगर ये हमारा एग्जाम ले रहे थे।
हाँ ले अब देखो वो तो यू नो राइट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कोरोना लाइक सब कुछ थोड़ा शिफ्ट हो गया है, 1-2 महीना डिले हो रहा है चीज। सो वही अब यूनिवर्सिटी का डेट जो देंगे हाँ वी कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग। तो अगर वो बोलेंगे कि अक्टूबर में करना है तो अक्टूबर में करना है, क्या कर सकते हैं। सो हाँ सो नाउ आई नीड टू बेक माई डिस्प्लेसमेंट मैप। सो अगर मैं यहाँ पर देखो मैंने ऑलरेडी कर लिया, हालांकि मैं दिखा देता हूँ, दिस वॉज माई एक्चुअल हाइपोथेसिस। जो ZBrush में बनाया स्पेयर से, दिस इज दैट मॉडल, ये पूरा दिस इज पूरा मॉडल। नाउ व्हाट आई डिड हियर इज नाउ यू कैन सी इज अ सॉलिड मॉडल एंड दिस वन इजंट द सॉलिड, दिस इज इजंट सॉलिड, दिस इज जो माया में बनाया है सेम मॉडल। व्हाट आई डिड इज एक्सपोर्टेड दिस मॉडल बिकॉज दिस हैव यू आई हैव अनरैप्ड इट। सो फेस को आई हैव गिवन मैक्सिमम स्पेस, नेक को थोड़ा सा स्पेस एंड हॉर्न्स को साइड में व्हाटएवर स्पेस वाज लेफ्ट आई जस्ट एडजस्टेड देयर एंड ईयर एंड एवरीथिंग प्लेस कर दिया, एवरीथिंग इज प्लेस्ड। सो मेक श्योर अनरैप द फेस बिकॉज फेस हैव मोस्ट ऑफ डिटेल्स, सो मेक श्योर गिव मैक्सिमम स्पेस एंड अनरैप इट प्रॉपरली। सो वंस अनरैपिंग इज डन वी कैन सी व्हाट फ्रंट फेस देयर इज नो सीन, फ्रंट नेक नेक एंड चेस्ट देयर इज नो सीम एट ऑल, बैक साइड वी हैव सीन ऑल द सीम्स बिकॉज इट्स नॉट विजिबल दैट प्रोमिनेंटली। सो आई विल बी फोकसिंग दिस सेक्शन ओनली। तो अभी देन आई एक्सपोर्ट दिस मॉडल लोएस्ट दिस मॉडल टू जी ब्रश। सो जी ब्रश में एक्सपोर्ट एंड देन गो टू जी प्लग, दिस इज नॉट देयर, दिस इज माई हाई पॉली एक्चुअल। अपेंड फ्रॉम सब टूल मास्टर मल्टी अपेंड अपेंड योर अनरैप्ड लू पॉली मॉडल अनरैप इट ब्रिंग इट हेयर एंड देन सब डिवाइड द मॉडल प्रोजेक्ट द प्रोजेक्ट बैक सब डिवाइड एंड प्रोजेक्ट सब डिवाइड एंड प्रोजेक्ट सो आई डिड दैट ऑलरेडी सो इफ यू सी डी सो आफ्टर हैव सब डिवाइड द मॉडल एंड प्रोजेक्टेड बैक ऑल द डिटेल्स फ्रॉम एक्चुअल हाई पॉली टू दिस अनरैप्ड मॉडल सो नाउ दिस बिकेम माई हाई पॉली मॉडल हाई पॉली मॉडल विथ अनरैप दिस इज क्लियर राइट इसमें कोई डाउट नहीं है
Yes, sir.
This is a very straightforward process. Import your unwrapped model and then project it and transfer all the info detail to a low poly model with subdivision and with unwrap. So once you're done with this, now this high poly is not required anymore. Basically, if you want, you can just simply delete that. So this is your low poly plus high poly. So now go back to lowest subdivision level or lowest subdivision level, go to Zplug. There's something called multi-map exporter. So whichever subdivision you are going to use for your rendering, make sure you are in this that particular subdivision level, like subdivision level 1, 2, 3, whatever you are going to use. I'm going to use one only, so I'm in one, and go click displacement map. Select your size 4K, 8K, whatever you want to select. You can select your map size from here. Export options, displacement, open. So now here what you can do, adaptive and smooth UV. Make sure switch on these two. These two are important. This dynamic subpixel is not required. This thing will basically increase the baking time tremendously, maybe like 10 times to increase the baking time. So but the result is almost the same. So no need to do this. Mid value is 0.5. Keep this value in your mind, 0.5. Then a 3-channel, we can do it, or you can keep it like a normal channel also. That's also fine. 16-bit, if you want, you can keep it 16-bit. Like these, all these things, for movies and all, we use 3-channel because it have more detail. So use all this thing, but if for personal portfolio and all, it's not required. And then all these two things, like 16-bit, if you want, you can keep it on, or you can switch it off also. But one thing you have to do is, you can see scale is 1, intensity is 0. So before transferring map, you need to calculate the scale. To get scale, click on this. It's calculating. And this will change with each and every model. Now you can see this scale become 4.4 and intensity is 0.17. So this is your displacement value that you need to put in your Maya. This value you need to keep in mind, though that is like, you don't have to remember, write it down. When you save, export this file, it will automatically, the name will start, not end with this number, this digit. So you can just copy it from there and use it. So 0.17395. So Maya can read only 3-digit decimals. So 0.173. And then once you're happy with this, all values, everything is set, just click on create maps. But one more thing, make sure export your cavity map also from ZBrush, because this will give you very high quality cavity map with all the pores and all the information that you will never get from Substance. So generate it from ZBrush itself for better output.
So I have a texture for me.
Huh?
Texture kaam pe karoge?
Substance.
Okay.
This is what I'm just explaining how to export displacement or Maya, how to use it and how to get the exact same render as high poly in Maya. Texture abhi start nahi kar rahe. Kal se kal wal se karenge start. So
tomorrow also it's a 3, sir.
What?
Tomorrow class is a 3, right?
3, same time. Yes, 3 o'clock.
Okay.
So you have this value is there. Everything is ready. And then you can click on create map. So, and just save it wherever you want to save. So I have already exported everything. You can see आई ट्राइड थ्राइस नॉट ट्वाइस बेसिकली वन मैप वन मैप आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सपोर्टेड एंड चेक एवरीथिंग एंड यू कैन सी एंड 0.173 एग्जैक्ट सेम वैल्यू सो आई हैव एक्सपोर्टेड दिस थिंग ऑलरेडी सो आई ऑलरेडी हैव अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट मैप रेडी प्लस आई हैव एक्सपोर्टेड माय कैविटी मैप आल्सो सो लेट्स सी लाइक नाउ आफ्टर डूइंग दैट एक्सपोर्ट दिस लो पॉली मॉडल डू नॉट यूज अ माया लो पॉली मॉडल इट वोंट वर्क प्रॉपरली because after projecting some dimension and volume will change slightly here and there so the displacement map won't work properly so make sure export the lowest division from ZBrush and then use the same model in Maya for rendering that will be your final low poly model like it's already unwrapped in Maya modeled in Maya but we are re-importing it into ZBrush and then projecting it back so make sure export the lowest division all UV everything will be intact nothing will change and it will give you better result so now I have opened my file that file and this thing is right now my work of ZBrush is done I can close this thing I don't need it anymore no yes
you have to put it to the lowest subdivision and then export displacement
yes lowest subdivision then export it like low whatever the lowest subdivision level 1 basically I have to export it so here
okay.
So I just import this file so this is my head and it's a skin material so that is I change it from here so that will show I'll redo the entire thing don't worry like I have like tested the render and everything it everything is working perfectly no issue at all so now eyes you need to create an eye lens which is slightly protruding outside like this and eyeball which is going inside so I can create this thing all is visible so everything is ready so my character and everything is ready so I created a render cam here I already created render cam and then set all the settings like this focal length and everything so let's I'm planning to render this thing out with displacement map and all so first you have to go to shapes Arnold scroll down subdivision and this subdivision is exactly the same value the number of subdivision you have in ZBrush like you can have extra not less so in ZBrush I have 5 subdivisions that's why 5 I can keep it 6 or 7 that is also fine but not less than 5 then if you have less than 5 then your render like displacement won't work properly it will give you like little hard edges and all those things scroll down displacement so here the scalar value I said 0.5 make sure it's 0.5 and the height is 0.173 that what you generated in ZBrush that 0.173 if you check that your exported map also you can see 0.173 so same value this is the value for displacement map with this exact value you'll get the exact same output of ZBrush so no need to manually change and tweak or do something okay 0.2 0.1 0.5 no 0.173 ZBrush gave you this exact value use the exact value you'll get the same result without changing anything and make sure switch on enable auto bump otherwise your bump won't work nicely your displacement won't work nicely so make sure switch it on now I need to create my shader so let's open it so though I have created the shader material everything is already ready so I'll just recreate this thing so in this I don't have any texture assigned it's just a basic material so I'll just create a new material for this select the model right click assign new material what Why assign new material is not working? That's strange. So anyways, so I can just create a material from here also. Arnold surface standard. Standard surface. Click this. This is my new material. So I can just name it as test. So I can identify this thing very easily. Select the head. Right click on this. Assign to viewport selection. So this is now a gray color material you can see. So I am not converting this into a subsurface as of now. I'll use this one only. So click on this. You can see the entire network, whatever is connected to your particular shader. That's a selected model. So right now, this is my main surface shader. Here you can see all the displacement map is here. So click this, go to displacement and click file. You can see file is here, select this, and now I'll copy my displacement map. So I have already saved this PSD as like JPEG. But one thing you need to modify in the exported displacement map to get better results. So I'll open and show you what I did here. If you have like a tens of texture, then it might crash. It's just one texture. So isme, this is what I have exported from ZBrush. I will zoom in and show you. Okay, huh. So you can see, if you zoom in, it kind of looks gray color and it's almost smooth. All those pores informations are there, but it's very like blurred or very light intensity. So what I did is I just duplicated the layer and applied a high pass. So with high pass, I got all this information. They're nice and crisp. I duplicated and merged it and overlay with the main displacement. So what happened? All my pores and all these like folds and all the wrinkles become nice and prominent. Make sure do not increase it way too much, like slightly, maybe in 4 or 5 high pass you can use. So you can use that and then add this detail, make it sure like slightly detailed. That's it. I just added this thing extra. That's it. Nothing else. Just to make sure all the wrinkles and pores are prominently visible. Close this. So now, this map I need to connect here. So shift right click, copy path, select the map, and V, open it. And one thing you have to make sure. Ignore color space, change it, and make sure it's in raw. No RGB, nothing else. Raw and ignore color space. Ignore color space, if you do it and don't do it, doesn't matter. If you don't do it, it will show you an error. If you switch it on, it won't show the error. That's the only thing. And as it's a grayscale map, color balance, make sure alpha's luminance is active. It's ticked on. So if it's not on, make sure it's on, otherwise it won't work properly. So these two things keep in your mind and select the model, double check your height value, 0.173.
This height value is what the...
From ZBrush. Okay, yeah, I guess you haven't joined that time. This is something ZBrush. There is an option. I'll just give me a second. Opening ZBrush. I'll show that.
No, just tell me the options name.
It's in like it opened. Just give me a second. It's in like once when you bake the multi-map, export multi-map. Yeah. Inside that there is an option called get a scale. See multi-map displacement export option. Displacement get skill. If you click on this, it will show you our intensity here.
Okay.
So it's 0.173. So this is the exact correct value I need to put into my displacement map value. So this will give me exact same output of ZBrush. This is the value of like of the map that I need to add. So this is only that thing. But anyways, if you get map and save it, you can see end of the map, there is a number 0.173. So you can read this and use that number very easily.
Yes, sir.
So now you have this file and I have applied everything. It's just a basic shader, nothing fancy. I haven't changed it to a skin shader or anything. So let's try it out, check it, because why I'm checking this right now, if there is anything I need to modify, I have to modify it right now, right away, and then I can texture it. Because after texturing, there is no point updating the model and UV and then redoing the texturing. That's stupidity. So I'll check the model and everything is working perfectly fine. Then I'll move to texture. So this thing is ready. And so what I did for this, I used a Arnold Skydome. And this HDRA map I have downloaded from HDRA Heaven. It's a free site where you can download all kind of HDRA maps. This particular one I really like. Reason, it gives me it acts as a backlight and gives me a really nice rim light. So that's why I prefer this one. So I kind of center, or maybe slightly off center. Like this, and plus if you see the front side, I have a lot of lights and poles. So it generates nice reflection in eyes as well. So I like this, but the face will be dark. So for this, what I'll do is I'll use a area light. Scale this thing. And I like to use disk so that it generates a circular shape. Reflection and angle slightly. Move it somewhere here. Center. Intensity. This is something I have tested already. So 100 and maybe 7 or 8. But I have tested this thing already. So 107.6 works perfectly. Now let's check this thing out. Okay, let's save it first. So all settings, everything is ready. Save the file. And if you want, just for render, you can just copy the file and save it as render file so that you don't mess up your actual file. Now go to render and let's test it out.
Sorry, Chinese me kyun aa raha
hai? Like I installed a plugin in my system from there only. A script, let's say like rigging script because of that.
Oh.
Let's give it a minute. It will load all the maps and everything, and then it will start rendering. But right now it's rendering perspective. I don't want it. I want it to render shapes. Why it's taking so much time? It's like IPR that should render quickly.
So you don't click on IPR?
No, this is like Arnold render, na? It's IPR only by default. Render. Why it's not rendering? Okay, it just created a TX map. Yeah, now it's in. What is this? Warning, your file type is healthy. That's a Chinese text. I don't have any clue. Like, I installed this plugin. After that, only this thing came. Anyways, if something happens, I'll reinstall. So here you can see it's rendering everything and all pores, wrinkles, everything is there. And I feel the intensity of the overlaid map is a little too strong. I can reduce it and then re-render it. But like everything is working, I can see. Everything is working. It's not distorting anything. Skin doesn't look like skin because there is no, I haven't applied any skin shader. So if I want to change this to a skin shader, just let's keep it here only and stop it. Select this, test. Just click on preset, skin, replace. And this will become skin shader. Now click render once again. Will take a little time and will render. Oh, one more thing I forgot to tell you. After exporting it from ZBrush, like everything is finalized, you exported your displacement and everything. Make sure scale your model to around 40 times, 30, 40 times. Because your skin shader works based on the size of the model. So if you increase it to 40 times, it will work normally and everything, all the translucency and everything will work perfectly. Otherwise, you have to manually change each and every value and you have to play around 0.001, 002 or 025, all those like decimals, and it will become really difficult to match. So increase the size of the model and then manually tweak things. And you can see the moment I change this thing, it's become soft and got the skin tone also automatically. It's rendering, let's move this to the side. So I want to change the light setting slightly. No, the intensity was 100, so I'm just changing that. So this is like I tested, like everything is working. So let's stop this and open your render view. This is my actual render. That outside that icon is there. I click that. And now I want to render this thing out. So first start with IBR, right click, render, render cam. I'll render this thing out. Then I'll render a region to check everything. Like everything is working perfectly. Because after applying the skin shader, also you have to tweak some roughness and all those things. or maybe some gloss, sheen, coat, all those things you have to modify slightly to get the proper nice skin tone or skin like gloss effect. It's still like time. So now I got the position and everything. I can stop it. And I'll go to settings, render settings. Open and Arnold to get a better result, like smoother and clearer, cleaner render. Increase the camera AA, this thing. So 7 usually works decently. It's basically a multiplier. So everything gets multiplied by 7. So everything increases. So higher the number, better the quality. But it increases your rendering time. So I want to render only and only one section. Only this section. So I can see everything here. And 1:1. And make sure auto resize is off. And now render. And like it's taking time, but rendering is a time consuming process. Zero percent only. Forever to render. finally, one box at least. So, like whatever I can see here, my character skin looks really matte. I cannot see any gloss here.
So that will anyways do while texturing it.
That will do, but like basically, it's only not just only roughness. We need to manipulate the shader as well. So let me escape this. This thing, that is something I'll check with this IPR only vendor with this. So what I do here is, so now I need to make it a little glossy. Select this thing. So to make it a nice realistic texture, the IOR, index of refraction, you need to increase maybe 1.5. Again, it varies from character to character. So based on your model, scale, size, everything, you have to change it. And plus coat. These two things we need to update. So right now you can see coat or sheen weight is zero. That means it's not giving any output. So you can increase it slightly. And coat is basically, again, it's a gloss, kind of gloss. So this is also going to increase slightly. You make it slightly glossy. Like instead of creating multiple maps, like you must have seen like a lot of tutorials and all, they create a specular map, they create a gloss map, or like all those multiple maps, right? So that's because of for all these things. You can manually create and assign those maps here under weight and generate everything. It started rendering. You can see this translucency, subsurface scattering. Automatically, the ears, like thin area, become transparent, translucent basically. You can see through. Still, I feel it's not that glossy, so I need to make it slightly glossy. Roughness, I can reduce. It's 0.5. Okay, that's why. The 0.3. Why it's not 3 and 3? Start rendering. just want to select basic glosses perfect fine, then we can just start section. Still, I need to make it a little glossier. Still, it's kind of matte. And subsurface, like a thin air, so I can see this redness. That is something we can definitely change. And we can make it, make the color slightly darker. It's like way too bright. Point 3 is fine. It should work. Oh, and this screen, it looks a little lighter, and this screen, the screen looks a little darker. You can see like all pores, lines, wrinkles, all details in detail nicely. So I can see lens, all these reflections are there. I can change light and all, I can modify things. So everything is kind of working perfectly. You can see, but there is no like unusual distortion or anything. So my displacement is working properly. My model is working properly. So now I can just simply push this model to Substance and start texturing this thing. So we can create texture nicely, add all the details. And for this kind of with displacement especially, we just need to add the color information. Only the color information, we don't need to add anything else. Maybe all those like molds kind of thing, I can add some color and rest everything like one basic tone, near to eye slightly red orangish tint and under eye slightly bluish hint of blue. This beard area slightly bluish greenish tint, lips reddish tint. And forehead is more of towards like a little desaturated and little yellowish in tint. And nose and cheekbones and ears a little reddish in tint. Those tone I just have to add and then render. So it will automatically, because with displacement, what happens, you have all the information in displacement and it will generate all the skin detail there. So you just have to add the color. Only color, and it will make make this entire thing look better. Yes, we have to work on roughness. That is something we need to make sure, like roughness is correct, all the values are correct, like all the pores should not shine. I have to make sure that all the wrinkles, lines, those things have to double check it's there, or there is any variation that is also to add there. Near to lips slightly shiny, nose slightly shiny, near to eye slightly shiny. Those things I need to make sure like those color informations are correct and those roughness values are correct, and then render it, and it will give me like a correct result like within no time, and it will look really nice within no time without any problem. Otherwise, like in games, you have to make sure your diffuse is really good, your roughness is very good, like all those maps have to focus. But in production, you just have to make sure colors are correct. You have correct colors in correct places, and to arrest everything will be handled by render. In my low poly, I only have this bump. all these things are not there. So everything is generated nicely. Here I feel it's like way too translucent, so I just need to reduce my subsurface radius, which is here. Subsurface radius, this one. Sorry, scale. I need to radius is color again. Scale I need to reduce slightly. If I reduce it, that orange tint will go. Like it's, it should be, it should reduce. It will become a little dark. Right, it's way too light and bright. In other screen, it looks really nice. Like, nice contrast and all. Gamma. 2.7. 4 point. I can like change the gamma exposure and all this thing. It's like same like Photoshop. I can manipulate the image. So if we make it a little dark, it will look nice. Yeah, see? Now this tone looks better. I can modify this like this also. You can see nose. So this render is working properly and shader is kind of set, not perfect, but now at least I have a base ready, and I just have to connect my materials, and then I might need to adjust few things here and there, and it should work perfectly without any problem. So checking your displacement is very important, because if there is anything distorting or any problem, then you have to go back to ZBrush and make sure your displacement map is baked properly, or everything is okay. Then you can start texturing, because now my model is freezed, my displacement is freezed, everything is ready. Now you can just simply start texturing the model. Stop it. It's way too much time. Stop this. So this file is base set, everything is ready. Let's save this thing. Unwrap is also ready. Now I'll just have to start texturing this and then render it out. Render setup is ready and everything is ready. So there's something else. Set something, some, I'll check that. What is it? Warning. So tomorrow, same time we have class, and tomorrow we'll create this thing. Start texturing this thing, and then we'll finish it up very easily. Almost everything is ready only. I just make sure everything is working properly. Okay, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.
In scales value, we'll have to put the value from ZBrush.
Yes. In Maya, select the model and then go to shapes, and there you have heights. In displacement attribute, there is height. That is your value from ZBrush. And the third number, there's another option is there, scalar zero value. That is basically your mid value. It's there in ZBrush, scalar value 0.5. It's by default 0.5 only. So put 0.5 there. That will work perfectly without any problem. Okay, then I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Thank you,
bye sir. Bye. Welcome.